Parallel and perpendicular line, question 21. Write equation of a line perpendicular to y equals to 3x passing through P, 5, 0. Now understand how I am solving this question so that you can solve the next question on your own. Question 22 is a part of your test. Write equation of a line perpendicular to y equals to 2x passing through point 2, minus 1. It's kind of very similar question to 21. So you should not have much difficulty in solving it. Okay, now here is how I'm going to solve question 21. Write equation of line perpendicular to y equals to 3x. When we say perpendicular to, then what do we mean? We mean that the slope of the line will be negative reciprocal of given line slope. So we know m perpendicular is equals to minus 1 over m. That is first thing. The second thing we know is passing through point P. So the point is given to us and point is 5, 0. So this will help us to find the y-intercept. Okay, so let's do it. We are given slope of a line is y equals to 3x. So what is, equation of the line is y equals to 3x. From here, 3 is the slope. So we know m is equals to 3. So slope of the line is 3. You can straight read it from the equation, right? Now, why you can read it? Because the equation is in the form of y equals to mx plus b. Coefficient of x is the slope of the line, and this is y-intercept, and therefore slope of the line is 3. 3 is the coefficient of x. So that is important to understand. The second part is, what is the slope of line perpendicular to this? Perpendicular should be negative reciprocal. Let me use this symbol m perpendicular. Do you see that perpendicular thing? It should be negative and reciprocal means 1 over 3. Do you see that? So that is negative reciprocal. So now we know what should be the slope of our perpendicular line. Okay, so that's a good information. With this, we can write down equation of our line. So let the equation of our line be in the form of y equals to mx plus b. Now here, what is m for us? M is minus 1 over 3. What is x and y? X and y is from the point. 5 is the x value and 0 is y value. So we'll write 0 for y, and for x I'll write 5 plus b. Correct? There is only one variable we can solve for it. So we get 0 equals to minus 5 over 3 plus b, and therefore b equals to, we'll take it on this side, 5 over 3, right? We'll add it, okay? I've seen students multiplying and then getting lost. Okay, so b is 5 over 3. Perfect. Now you know b, you know m. Can you write down the equation? I think so. So what do you know? Let me write again. We know m of the perpendicular line is minus 1 over 3 and b is 5 over 3, right? And therefore, equation in the terms of y equals to mx plus b can be written as y equals to minus 1 over 3x plus b, which is plus 5 over 3. So that is your answer. Now let me add something to this. Sometimes in the questions, they will say write answer in standard form. Do you understand standard form? Standard form is, let me write here, standard form. Standard form is of the form of ax plus by plus c equals to 0. That means everything should be on one side of equality, the other side is 0. So to write this in standard form, what we can do is, we can multiply everything by common denominator and then bring terms together. So if I multiply everything by 3, I get 3y equals to minus x. There's no point writing 1. Plus 5. This is the first part. Second, we want 0 on one side, all other terms here. Another important thing is a should be positive. I mean x coefficient, these are called coefficients, right? So a, b are coefficient. What are these called? Coefficients. C-O-E-F-F-I-C-I-E-N-T-S. Coefficients. This is coefficient of x. This is b is coefficient of y. Okay. So when we bring this side, x becomes positive. So we get x. And then we already have 3y here. 5 becomes negative and then equal to 0. You see that? So that is the answer in standard form. Okay. So I'll appreciate if you could also write answer in standard form for question 22. So question 22 is your test problem. I hope you have understood the way I have explained question 21. Follow the same steps and get your answer for question 22. Okay, all the best. If you have any problems, you can always write down your comments and I'll get back to you. Thank you.